AI video made huge strides this week with some incredible content coming from Luma AI. The Luma Labs videos are insane. And in this video, we're going to break down some of the dopest videos. And I'm going to show you how you can create your own AI-generated videos. We're going to do that on our own. It's going to be fantastic. If you like this type of content, if you like AI, tech, the future of business, this is the time you hit subscribe. But before we get into that, I do want to show you where AI was 1 year ago, because I know what you scrubs are going to say. You're going to say, Mark, AI's not that cool. It's not ready. AI video sucks. Look at where things have come in just 12 months. This is a picture of a video of Will Smith. This is a video of Will Smith eating spaghetti a year ago. This is where it's at now. Look at this. I mean, obviously, it's a little ridiculous watching Will Smith eat spaghetti, but this looks actually pretty real. This is actually pretty real. I don't know why he's eating that guy's dreadlocks, but you know, but look where AI was a year ago. So don't sit there and tell me that AI video is not a big deal, okay? Just don't say. Or tell me in the comments, yell at me. I'm not wearing my hat today. I know you like to yell at me for wearing my hat backwards. Whatever. I don't care. It's not on. It's not backwards. But that's besides the point. Let's check out some dope videos. Let me give Luma AI Labs a follow because their video content is just bananas. And let's see some of the videos that are coming out of Luma Labs here. AI generated. Are you not entertained? That is bananas. And I know this is one of the funny things that happens with AI. And, you know, I'm sharing stuff on my Twitter feed all the time. But people say stuff like, oh, yeah, I could tell that was AI generated because, like, the shading or the way that her hair was laying is like, bro, if you were scrolling through your Instagram feed, if you're scrolling through Twitter, there is no way you would know it's AI generated unless someone told you it was AI generated. I promise you. Look at that. Look how real that looks. That is crazy. That is so crazy. Look at this car. You're going to sit there and tell me, oh, yeah, I knew that was an AI-generated car. Bull crap. You didn't know. Look at this. This is so nuts. Look at the lighting. Look at the light. Look at the light glare off of her skin. Look at the glasses, the slight mirror image on the glasses. You're telling me you can see that? That is unreal. And by the way, this girl is beautiful, like a perfect 10 out of 10. So just a hot take, hot prediction. Within 5 years, half of humans, high schoolers in particular, you're super subject to this. Half of high schoolers are going to be dating chatbots like this. You thought that, you know, the internet is for porn was a big deal. Just wait till you get AI avatars doing this. And, you know, by the way, I got an 8-year-old daughter. She's going to have to compete. When she goes to school and all the guys are looking at this type of image, she's going to have to compete with that. That's a huge issue. All my dads out there with daughters, type in the comments below if that's something that you're concerned about, because I'm concerned about that. Because confidence, we often look for confidence and validation out there. We need to look for it from within. Anyway, these videos are so cool. Look at that cheetah there. That cheetah looks so real. Look at the fire, the explosions. Look at that. That is, it's just jaw-dropping from where we were a year ago. So, you know, the other thing that's interesting is, like, this is why SAG-AFTRA was, this is a big reason why SAG-AFTRA in California was on strike. Because they know all those background actors that you need to pay HR to hire, you need directors, you need to worry about them showing up sick, you know, they're sitting around, you're paying benefits, you got to feed them all. You're not going to need to do that anymore. All the background actors are going to be AI generated. Not a doubt in my mind. Now, like when you look at a movie studio and the way they're filming videos now, like you look at a movie like Braveheart, for example, there's huge fight scenes and that sort of thing. You are not going to need all those actors and actresses. You're not going to need all the lighting and the drones. You're not going to need any of that. You're going to be able to generate it with AI almost instantly. In fact, Ashton Kutcher had a video about that. So anyway, this is going to just change the industry tremendously. You're still going to have like your premier actors and actresses, like your Ryan Reynolds, your The Rock, Scarlett Johansson. Like, they're going to still be a big deal, I think. Although, also another hot prediction, some of your favorite actors and actresses are going to be AI. Hot take. That's going to happen. Look at the water. Look how well it does water. That's crazy. So before we actually get into how to actually generate your own videos, I just want to show you some more videos that are generated by the community. Here's an image of a samurai. Look at that. The sword is looking a little bit weird here, a little bit funky, but it's holding together pretty well. What's also interesting here is this video is 10 seconds long. It's very rare to see good AI video that's long. But this video is really solid. Smoke, the lighting, all of that is bananas. Super, super dope. Let's look at some more examples here. I'm a dog guy, but I can dig it. Cat looking into the solar system. There's something in the background. It's kind of weird. Not that impressive to me, but still pretty cool. Let's check out this video here. Guy and girl loving on each other. Let's look for the nose. The nose is kind of being absorbed into her forehead a little bit. But overall, I think this is the type of thing that if you were just scrolling through Instagram real quick, this is the type of thing like a 2 second, 3 second clip could work. And again, it starts to get a little bit funky around 2 seconds, which is typically what I'm seeing in AI generated video. If you're doing short clips, a short B-roll for your videos, I think it's, you know, the 2 second clips can work. And when you get over 2 seconds, things can So this is something that I'm very intrigued by, is hyper-realism, right? Like, how real? Look at this lady's head, by the way. It's pretty wild. No, you know, before I analyze it, let's just watch the video real quick. We're watching this woman in the foreground. She's just walking. There's a snapshot. Looks pretty real to me. Looks pretty real. And by the way, this video is a minute and 19 seconds, which again is one of the challenges. Oh, now we're less focused on this woman and we're following this guy who's walking. I gotta say, I find this very, very impressive. And you can see that as you're looking here, there's still some weird stuff that's happening. Now the guy has a mask on all of a sudden. Now everybody has a mask on. That's actually kind of creepy. That's actually super creepy. Nobody in the beginning had a mask on. Then all of a sudden, everyone has a mask on. So, but you can see some minor hallucinations here where people are kind of being absorbed in and out of objects. But again, if you were just kind of glancing through the video real quick, you wouldn't notice. This is the type of thing that you wouldn't notice. Here's a car that's being merged into another car over here. That's interesting. Let's back that up for you. You can see this car is kind of like in the side of that car. So yeah, there's some weird stuff, but let's look at this here. All these people here look real. All these people look real. Look at them. They all look real. The faces are hyper realistic. So I find this super fascinating, super fascinating. And again, you've got some weird stuff. I also find it super trippy that in the beginning of the video, no one's wearing a mask. Later in the video, everyone's wearing a mask. Might remind you of a certain pandemic that hit. Crazy. Anyway, this is actually, I think, a really cool example of where AI is now. And again, if we were to generate the same type of video a year from now, my bet is it looks really, really good. And if you disagree, type it in the comments below. But that's the reason why I started this video showing you the Will Smith eating spaghetti last year versus Will Smith eating spaghetti this year. And by the way, you want a real trip, watch a video of Will Smith watching AI Will Smith eat spaghetti. That's a trip. Let's check out a couple more videos here. Okay, so this is a cool one. There's a new prompt here called Extend. There's an Extend feature. And what this is going to allow you to do is make your videos longer. So if you make a 4 second clip, it's going to make it longer. And, you know, there was another video I recorded of a music video that I want you to check out, which is kind of what this looks like. It's all extend, extend, extend. I'm going to put a link to that video right up here. That's definitely worth checking out what's happening in the music video genre, but I think this is super cool. It's super cool. And, you know, you could film a video like this using a drone, but what if we were to change it from a cavern with rocks and with water, but instead it was you're traveling on Mars, right? You're traveling on Mars. You're traveling in a very dangerous crevice or something like that. Super, super cool. Oh, we got to see this one. This one here is someone who ran Midjourney through Luma Labs. Look at this. You would not know that this was AI generated. No freaking way. No freaking way you would think that this was AI generated. Look at that. I'm seeing at the very end there, maybe there's a slight hallucination at the end there, but otherwise, this is just straight fire. This is why every guy in the United States is going to be addicted to this on their phone. Like it or love it. Oh, this is a cool one. Extend videos. So you might recognize this clip from The Shining, but watch this. As he's writing, by the way, looks really real. Looks pretty real. And as he goes farther and farther, this door kind of turns into a hallway, which it makes the transition, I think, pretty naturally, but it's still a little weird. This is actually super creepy. At the very end here, you can see some figures walking. If you've seen The Shining, old movie, you know how freaking creepy that is, but oh, come on, you can see these figures. Hotel guest, maybe they don't want to leave. I don't know. But I think this is another really cool example of what's happening. This is kind of interesting too. All these different little cute cartoon characters made in Midjourney, which, you know, if you look at the history of animation, when, let's say, Walt Disney started animating Mickey Mouse back in the early 1900s, in the early 1900s, it was so laborious. He was drawing all these images on paper and then flipping them through. Even modern day image generation, like with companies like Pixar, is extremely expensive. So, and you know, quick side note, I think that a lot of the modern Disney storytelling is just garbage. It's trash. It sucks. It's not interesting. It's just rehashing old stuff or just adding like weird theory and ideology. I don't care for it. Love it, hate it. I don't like it. You might love it. Good for you. Mazel tov. But what I think is going to be interesting here is that with this new technology, young movie studios are going to be able to adapt the technology and write better stories, create better, more interesting characters, and use AI technology to be extremely competitive in creating images like this and characters like this. So again, we're not quite there yet, but come back at me in a year. Tell me I'm wrong. I think I'll be proven right. Here's another one here. A woman, there's so many amazing examples. So I just find this endlessly fascinating. So listen, let's shift over to lumalabs.ai, their dream machine. And let me show you how easily you can create your own videos, okay? So what we're going to do here is we're going to go up to the top right and we're going to try it now. And then you just type in whatever you want, or you could just take an image and copy and paste in there. So I'm gonna show you an image that I uploaded here, okay? This is an image of me at Washington, D.C. that I uploaded. I had the honor of going to D.C. with Meta, and quite frankly, I think this video looks super solid. Now, my nose starts getting kind of funky at the end. If you check out the nose there, it starts getting weird. But overall, I think it's super, super good. I also am not sure exactly how how architecturally accurate this is. This is the Capitol building. And you could also see that the letters on my shirt start to get weird. Okay, so again, we have some hallucinations near the end of the clip. Otherwise, I think pretty cool, pretty cool. Let's watch another video. This was a prompt, a video of a blonde-haired father and his son having fun at a dinosaur-themed park. And again, the first couple seconds work out, but then the nose gets weird, and then he like there's a weird woolly mammoth in the background. And so this is just kind of weird. And again, one of the questions in my mind is, how many millions of prompts had to go in to get that ultimate response? The other question I have here is, you know, I'm on a free tier. By the way, you can try this for free. I'm on a free tier. If I'm paying, am I going to get a better result? All questions, I think, need to be answered. Anyway, kind of interesting. Here's another prompt here. A father and daughter skating on a beautiful, on top of a beautiful mountain in Colorado. So I think it's pretty interesting. I don't know what they're holding here. They look like weird hockey sticks. What I do think, though, is that the background is very compelling. These video, I mean, this looks pretty realistic. There's some minor hallucinations. Again, it's not quite there. It's just not quite there. But I think if I was to keep tweaking and trying and altering this, I think I could come up with a better prompt. Also, by the way, I have an entire ChatGPT guide at AIupdate.ai. One of the tricks that you can do is you can use a program like ChatGPT, ask it to give you a prompt for AI video, and you can use AI tools like ChatGPT to give you better prompts. You tell it what you want to do and have it give you a better prompt. I have an entire guide at AIupdate.ai. It's completely yours. It's completely free. All my best stuff. Go to AIupdate.ai. You can get that free guide. I'll even put a link below so you can check that out. The other thing that I've been seeing online a lot is memes. So here's a classic meme of the Doge coin, Shiba Inu coin, I guess. Shiba Inu. It's really funny. That Doge meme, it gets me every time. And it looks real. I think this is one of the best ones that I've actually created. I'll probably upload this onto Twitter under my name, Mark Savant. This is pretty good. It's pretty good. Here's another one. A Tesla car on Speedway racing against Formula One vehicles. And I think this is pretty interesting. Like the first 2 seconds, I think look really good. Then it gets a little bit weird. But again, if I can just get the first 2 seconds to get someone's attention, boom, 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 then we're off to the races. But pretty interesting. Here's another meme of Kevin Hart. He's doing his face, and all of a sudden he transforms. So this one just completely misses the mark, but it is kind of funny how he moves. Like, again, if you took the first couple seconds, but in my case, you might have some different examples. You can put your links below, but for me, if I go past 2 seconds, it gets a little bit wonky. And then my last one here was just an image of Elon Musk, another meme, and it just zooms in, which I find interesting. So I would love to see what you're playing with. Hit me up on Twitter, tag me, all that good stuff. Write your comments below. I think there's some really, really dope. Oh, this is a good one here. This is actually a great meme. You might remember this meme. It looks pretty realistic. His fingers start to get weird and he starts to kind of change. His face kind of changes. So you can see what happens. Again, the longer the video goes, the harder because at the end of the day, what do AI models do? What are these large language models doing? They're predicting what happens next. And so the farther the prediction gets away from the original source text, original source image, the farther it gets away from that, the harder time it has, the more difficult it is for it to predict what's next. What is the next frame of this video? So they're going to keep working on it. We're going to keep tweaking it. I'm going to keep reporting on the best stuff. Thanks for subscribing. This is what we're covering here, baby. How to get the most out of your content. And I'll see you in the next video. All right, peace.